We're on our way to Wombath's airfield for the last time, and that's because the Bushbaby is finally coming home. And so today will be the first time that I'm flying it with the new 912 Xtra engine, so I'm very much looking forward to that. And stick around to the end of this video where I will do an initial impressions of the Bushbaby with the 912 Xtra engine. Bushbaby was finally ready to fly. Test flights had been completed and we also finally put on VGs. It was time to go up and get acquainted with our new beast. And then it was time to take her home.
Charlie, it's a Bushbaby, approximately 3 miles to the south of Wombath Airfield, 4,400 feet, climbing to 5,500, starting to run a park here. Yeah. Engine Charlie. And I'm only now leveled out, I'm picking up quite a bit of speed here. Yeah? Like nothing this plane has done before. Okay, we're more or less leveled out now, just below 5,300 RPM. Saving 90 miles per hour indicated. Cruise speed 98 miles per hour. 5,000 RPM, 81 miles per hour indicated. 82, cruise speed 90 miles per hour at 5,000 RPM. And this thing has never climbed like this before. I was just seeing 800 feet per minute here a second ago. 8,800 density altitude. This is a machine now. So I thought with a heavier engine we were going to need a lot of back pressure on this thing. More straight and level, but I'm actually getting quite a lot of forward stick. And this plane doesn't have elevator trim, so I'm just using a bit of tiny bit of flaps to trim it nose down. Yeah, now it's more or less
in the east Middleburg area. November Yankee Foxtrot, we to the east of Middleburg at 6,000 feet, QNH 1025.
No level traffic, rest of winter area. India Juliet Charlie is a Bushbaby, 5 miles to the northwest of Westminster Dam at 6,500 feet, booting to Rana Park in India Juliet Charlie. Charlie over at the field, 6,300 feet. We'll be joining a right hand circuit for runway 11 on the gravel, runway 6. Final approach, runway 11 on the gravel, runway inspection. Charlie turning a final approach, runway 11 on gravel, full stop land. So this is a 3-pointer. Okay, we've made it. But man, it's good.
You have her home.
Okay, we finally made it home. The Bushbaby is back home in her hangar. So, how awesome is that?
Okay, let's cover some performance numbers followed by my initial impressions. Cruise speed seems to have gone up about 15 miles per hour from a Rotax 582's 80 miles per hour true air speed to now 95 miles per hour. Climb performance was difficult to determine because it was a hot afternoon with a lot of up and down drafts, but it seems to have gone up from an average of 350 feet per minute on the Rotax 582 to now about 750 feet per minute. Two people up, we seem to be getting about 500 feet per minute. Landing performance shouldn't be affected, but I found that I can now do perfect three pointers, where before the upgrade on landings, the mains touched first, no matter what I tried. And the reason for that is the change in the tailplane angle that was made for the heavier 912 from the top position to the bottom position. Okay, so now for my subjective first impressions. On my very first flight, I wasn't exactly overwhelmed by the change in performance, though it was definitely there. We were two up, so we were fairly heavy and it was a very hot day. I've since flown the plane again at my home field, also two people up, and even though I won't call it a monster performer, it was just so good not having to struggle to climb out like with the previous engine. So how does it feel to fly it? It definitely feels like a different aircraft, and that isn't in a good or bad way, but I just wasn't immediately comfortable like I was with the previous engine. That is likely because the propeller turning the other way around than the Rotax 582. So right turning tendencies has now become left turning tendencies. More right rudder, right? You saw in the video me doing some Dutch rolls to try and get my rudder aileron coordination more accurate, because it just didn't feel spot on at the time. Regarding the propeller, I don't have anything to compare it to, so it will be fairly pointless for me to give an opinion. Currently for our mission, we want the propeller to be set for both climb and cruise performance, not really favoring one over the other. We seem to be getting around 5,300 RPM climbing out at 65 miles per hour. So overall, was all this really worth it? Yes, totally. A huge thanks to Benchmark Aviation for all the work they did on India, Juliet, Charlie, and for letting my dad and I work on the bigger luggage bay in their workshop. I've put a link to their website in the description of the video. Let me know in the comments if there's anything else you would like to know. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.